Our goal is to purify the mind. We discussed to purify the mind, just chant the name of God. But this tool is weak. If you can learn the art of visualization, you will have a tool that will be 1,000 times more powerful than mere chanting of the name of God. A picture is worth 1,000 words. So an image is always more powerful. And as a self-transformation tool, you can use it. The power of visualization was graphically revealed by a testimonial of one Russian Jew called Nathan Sharansky. He was a Jew living in communist Russia, and he was accused of being an American spy and thrown into jail. He describes the conditions in jail. They were so bad. For 400 days, he was in the Siberian jail, the worst of them all. His prison cell was 4 feet by 3 feet, where he used to live. Now, in such a place, your body will start deteriorating for lack of exercise, and the brain will also start deteriorating. So he had this will to remain all right. Of course, for his body, he would do anti-gravity exercises. But what to do for the brain? As a child, he was fond of chess. He said, "I will play chess in the mind." Now, you keep 64 squares in the mind. Naturally, it will be a big gymnastics. So every day, he used to play chess in his mind. And with whom to play? So he would say, why not play with the world champion?
Check.
The world champion in those days, his name was Garry Kasparov. So he used to play with Garry Kasparov in the mind. He stayed in jail for 12 years. After 12 years, when Bill Clinton became the president of USA, he made an appeal to the Russian government, and the Russian government released him. He went out of jail and he went to live in Israel, where he became a cabinet minister. Now, Garry Kasparov, he came on a visit to Israel. These grandmasters and world champions played demonstration matches. In the demonstration match, they will take on 5 players at a time or 40 players at a time. So on this day, Garry Kasparov was playing against 5, 1 against 5. He defeated 4 of them, but he lost to 1 person. And the person whom he lost to was Nathan Sharansky. The reporters asked him, "Sir, how did you defeat the world chess champion? You are not a grandmaster or anything of the sort." He said, "You know, for 12 into 365 days, I was defeating him every day in my mind. So I had got programmed to defeat him was the most natural thing for me." Like as you keep typing, it becomes natural for you. So to defeat him was the most natural thing, because he had visualized it again and again and again. He had programmed his subconscious for victory against the world chess champion. That was the power of visualization. Now people are used to making New Year resolutions. I will get up at 5 o'clock every day. I will do this, I will not do that. They write the New Year resolution in their diary and then they close the diary. So those words which you wrote, within a few days they have slipped out. And the whole year passes by. Next New Year again you remember, oh, New Year resolution. One person went to the gym on 3rd of January. He found the whole parking lot was jam-packed. He had to wait 10 minutes for an empty spot. And when he went into the gym, in front of every machine there was a queue. He asked the gym manager, "What's going on? Are you running out of space?" The gym manager said, "Sir, these are the New Year resolution people. You wait for 10 days, everything will be back to normal." The same New Year resolution, if you had made it with images, you visualize every day in the morning at 6, I'm going to the gym and I'm doing yoga or whatever, and kept that image for 1 minute, you would not have forgotten it. Again, the sports arena, they utilize the power of visualization. The number one golfer in American golf history has been Jack Nicklaus. The Jack Nicklaus, he is still alive, he gives his testimonial. He says, "I never hit the ball before properly visualizing the whole terrain and the track and the ball in flight from the club and flying through the air and rolling into it." So he knows that if the conscious mind is to control the musculoskeletal system, it will be an impossible task. Itni to buddhi nahi hai. But if the subconscious can come into play, then things will become automatic. So he first holds the image within himself and then goes for it. The sports people realize that. One sports psychologist, John Murray in Florida, he has coached many Olympic champions. So he says, when you want to serve the ball in tennis, you first visualize the ball in flight going and hold that image, which corner of the court you want to see the ball landing, and then you throw the ball and hit it. But the same visualization can be utilized to bring our subconscious into play in any realm in life. One philosopher used it to heal himself. This was a gentleman called Norman Cousins. He is no more now, but he wrote a book, Anatomy of an Illness. He was diagnosed with leukemia, blood cancer. He said, "You know, I will tap into the power of my mind. This is mind over matter." He is using the power of thoughts to heal the body. He describes his meditation. He describes that daily he would sit and meditate, that millions upon millions of WBCs, white blood corpuscles in his blood, they are going and attacking these cancer cells and eating them up and finishing them up. So he would do it every day, visualize it. That visualization went straight to the subconscious, which changed his bodily processes, and his leukemia went into remission. He continued to live for another 20 years through that power of visualization. Now, how do we use this tool for our benefit? Our goal is to purify the mind. You purify the mind by attaching it to the all pure God. To purify your mind and the subconscious, you want to make them divine. And how to make them divine? So simple. You visualize the image of your Ishtadev, of your Lord.